Okay, so now this page of the slides, I just opened it by mistake, but I think it is relevant for the beginning of this course, this lecture. Now, as you have probably seen your grades in the quizzes, I read your quizzes. These were the warnings, some notes that I had prepared after the second quiz, but I think it still holds. Now, acceleration is in the direction of change in velocity. Well, not that one, but if there is no force, then there is no acceleration, i.e. no change in velocity. Now, 80% took the quiz, the third quiz. And I think more than 70 of them, well, that is around 90% or so, they had a centrifugal force pointing away from the center of the circle. So that you had this circular orbit, the forces, you had the tension force, and then you had the force in the opposite direction. And then you just write that the net force is zero, so mv squared over r should be equal to the tension. If f net is zero, there is no acceleration. If there is no acceleration, the velocity is constant. If velocity is constant, then the direction of the velocity cannot change, so you don't have circular motion. If you have circular motion, you cannot have a... If f net is zero, you cannot have any circular motion. Now, one thing I observed in your quizzes is that you still stick to the way of solving you had when you were in high school. And although I say that, I tell you that there is no centrifugal force, the force is always towards the center, it is always toward a centripetal force, apparently I'm not being able to convince you. Well, that is not something bad in itself. You shouldn't be convinced about anything just because somebody else tells you that it is so. You should always judge what you hear. But once there is evidence against what you believe, as scientists, you are supposed to change the way you are thinking. So that step seems to be missing for some reason. So for that reason, I would like to make a demonstration today. So I want all of you to go back in the corridor. I mean, just make one row in the last seat of this block and another row in the first seat of the other block. Get up. You will be just watching the demonstration. You don't need to take anything with you. Well, I will be using this space. So some of you should go there in this first row, some to the first row. There, oraya ya da oraya. Yeah, you should be standing up and looking back. I will need some volunteers. I need 3 volunteers. Okay. Other volunteers? Tamam, sen de kal. Okay, so I don't want 3 guys. At least 1 girl, please. So which one of you is sitting back? Well, okay, you can stay. Now, you can stand up over there. I mean, this space we will be using only, from there to there. I don't think we will be using more space. So your everyday life experience. You are in a car. The car is at rest. Araba duruyor. And then it accelerates. So, araba hızlanmaya başladı. What is the direction of the force that you feel? The car is accelerating in that... Okay, let's say the car is accelerating in that direction. So what is the direction of... In the same direction, backwards. How many of you think that you'll feel a force backwards? Okay, you feel backwards. You feel backwards. You feel backwards. I want to see more hands because I'm sure that at least 80% of you believe that the force is pointing backwards. But whenever somebody asks you what's the direction of force acting on you, the acting on you is back. Okay, acting on you. The force acting on you is back, right? Yes? How many of you hand sense? Okay, so. Okay, so this will be our accelerating car. You come here. Hold this. Well, this is the car. Well, this is the car. And this is your you sitting on the car, if I can. If it's still. No. No. Okay. Now, I want you to stand right parallel to it, right over there. You will stand there. I want you to move with the car, with the seat. Yeah, yes, you will move with it. And. Okay, fine. So you will be moving, you will be staying there, and you just start running or push it really hard. Yes, now. Okay, yes, yes. Okay. Sorry, sorry. That was my mistake. Let's do it again. Well, that's the idea. Okay, let's forget this one. It doesn't stay there. But this is you in the car. I should move away. Okay. Start. Okay, so which direction did it accelerate? You. So that is the direction that you accelerate. So for you, which direction did it accelerate? Back. For him, it is accelerating in the backwards direction. So what should be the direction of the force that it feels? What is the direction of the force acting on it? Yeah, so you are the passenger and the force acting on it is in this direction. So, arabadasınız, araba bu tarafa gidiyor. Siz ileri doğru gidiyorsunuz. Dolayısıyla size etki eden kuvvet ileri doğrudur. Was this convincing evidence? Come on, be honest. If you don't think that it was convincing, you can say so. Okay, so we had these two examples. Your friend, well, you can just imagine him or him as the drivers. They will, when they look at you, they see that you are going backwards. So there's a force, it looks as if there is a force acting on you in the backward direction. So, bu arkadaşlarınıza göre, birisi şoför, öbürü yanınızdaki yol arkadaşınız, bu geriye doğru gitti. So, onlara göre geriye doğru gidiyorsunuz. Geriye doğru bir force. The observer will be important, but remember, when we are talking about the force, we are always talking about Newton's law. Kuvvetten bahsettiğimiz zaman, her zaman için Newton yasalarından bahsediyoruz. And Newton's laws are valid only in inertial reference frames. Newton yasaları da sadece eylemsiz referans sistemlerinde geçerli. Now, these two friends are not inertial reference frames. They are accelerated. So I cannot talk about force in their reference frame. Şimdi bu arkadaşlarınız eylemsiz referans sisteminde olduğu için bu arkadaşlara göre bir kuvvetten bahsetmemin bir anlamı yok. Çünkü orada zaten kuvvet tanımlı değil. The force is not defined for them. Of course they will observe me or you sitting in the back of the car moving backward, but there is no point in talking about the force there because it is a non-inertial reference frame. The force is not defined there. Kuvvetten bahsetmek istiyorsam kullanabileceğim mutlaka bir inertial reference frame kullanmam lazım. When I'm talking about the force, I have to use an inertial reference frame. Your friend is an inertial reference frame sitting here, and according to him, in an inertial reference frame, you accelerated in that direction. So the force acting on you is in that direction. So I will be doing one more example. Circular motion. So you two just stand in two opposite corners, you to the other end. Well, let's move a bit to this side. He will need to take a turn. a bit further away. So, you just stand here. Now you come over there. Let's move a bit backwards. Okay, so what I want you to do is to start accelerating slowly so that it will stay there. But I want you to reach a sufficiently high speed and make the turn down the stairs. But you should run towards your friend on the line until there. Yes, you start. You should be running a bit more fast. That's right again. All right. That was kind of too fast. Remember, your friend first is running in that direction, in a line. Okay, let's try another move. Run that direction and turn around. Now, first run along this line as much as possible, then make a left turn. Or if you are, okay, you are right-handed, run along this line towards your friend. So you move a bit towards the right. So you are running towards her first, and then making a fast turn. Okay. I hope. Is your foot fine? So. Did this mass move in that direction? Come on. It moved in that direction, and when your friend took a left turn, well, it was a bit deflected towards the left. A bit. I mean, it didn't hit the right leg, it hit the left. No, it didn't hit the left leg, it hit the right leg, right foot. So it did make a very small shift towards in that direction when your friend turned around. Agreed? So what should be the direction of the force acting on this in this vertical direction? In this direction, right? Yes or no? No. So, no? Yes. No, okay, so there are many forces acting on this. But your friend was first running in this direction. Then he turned the left turn. This mass just went and hit the foot a bit shifted towards the right. Left, sorry. So it, let's do it again. We will discuss that. First, I mean, you don't need to go until your friend. So it will be able to move a bit further away. We will see how, in which direction it is deflected. Okay. Now, can you lift that bag? No, not you. Somebody over there. I have a bag over there. Okay. So that is our line going straight. Well, you were supposed to run towards your friend, but nevertheless, I think it was kind of obvious he was running towards him. But this thing just hit over here. So how many of you could see that? Okay, so you saw it. So initial velocity was pointing in that direction until he turned around. Yani ilk baştaki hızı, vektörel hızı bu yöndeydi. Ne oldu sonra? Arkadaşınız döndü. Tabi bu takip edemedi. Well, this couldn't follow. But nevertheless, the vector shifted a bit from here to there. You agree? So the change in its velocity, hızındaki değişim, was in this direction. So initially it was a vector like this, then it became a vector like this, so the change is the vector like this. That is the acceleration. Yeah. If we measure divided by the time it takes to move from there to there, it gives us the acceleration. That is the force that it feels. But yani ivmesi bu yönde, dolayısıyla onu etki eden kuvvet de bu yönde. Bunu etki eden. Agreed? Yes or no? Are you sure? So in the next quiz, when I ask you the direction of the force, you will have the right answer. We will see that. We will test that. So that was the direction of the force. Now, this thing fell off the car from the back, more or less. So if you are sitting in the car, arabanın arkasından düştü sonuçta. If you are in the car, when the driver looks at you, he will see you pushed backwards. That is what he will observe as a driver. Şimdi arabanın arkasından düştüğüne göre, bu patlamış. Şoföre göre siz arkaya doğru ivmelendiniz. According to the driver, you are accelerated backwards. Although the force, according to him, according to all of you, was in that direction, towards the center, you fall backwards from the corner. If you are taking this turn, you fell off from that corner. So according to the driver, if he would believe that his frame is an inertial reference frame, he would have said that, okay, the force is backwards. But his reference frame is not inertial. We cannot talk about force there. Şimdi sürücüye göre, sürücü ne diyecek? İşte sağa döndü, sola döndü, arkadaşının sağ taraftan uçtu. Şoföre göre arkadaşımıza sağa doğru bir kuvvet itti. Ama şoförün referans sistemi inertial olmadığından orada bir kuvvetten bahsedemeyiz. Kuvvet tanımı Newton yasalarında sadece inertial reference frame'ler içindir. The force is only defined for inertial reference frames. It is not defined for non-inertial reference frames. Now, there are tricks to define it, but forget about them for the time being. Force only exists in inertial reference frames. So whenever you are talking about the force, you should always talk about inertial reference frames. Not in the reference frame of your friend, which is not inertial. Any other questions? Any other doubts? Yes. Of course we will, because the seat is pushing him. The guy is not going back. The question is this one. I will repeat in English. I'm an outside observer looking at the driver. So he just leans on the steering wheel. So he just sits, leans a bit forward. Then he just pushes the wheel. So he's accelerating. He pushes really hard, so he will be accelerating really hard. So what you will observe is that the driver is just forced back to the seat. Do we have a wheelchair or a chair with some wheels? No, okay. Yakında mı? Well, that would be a bit... I thought about that, but it might be dangerous. So, he's asking, okay, we see the driver push back on the seat. So, isn't there a force pushing the driver back? Now, what I'm saying is, in that example, it's not the driver is being pushed back. It is the wheel which is pushed forward by the car. Of course, if I translate this interpretation, now it doesn't have wheels. Yere yazık olur. Ona da yazık olur. Well, it's the same thing. If we had some wheel chair with wheels, then if you just sit leaning forward, if I push the chair, now you will not claim that there's a, I mean, I'm pushing the chair, so the person sitting there will just be squashed to the back of the chair, but it's because I'm pushing the chair. The chair is accelerating. Şimdi araba örneğine dönecek olursak, arabada olan olay şoför arkaya yapışmıyor. Orada olan olay koltuk öne gidiyor. Exactly. You are not, are you really sure that you are feeling a force backward? You are being pushed backwards. That's true. I mean, you, your body will move backwards in the reference frame of the car. But what is happening, if you are sitting there, if I hold your feet and pull them, well, you will agree that the force acting on you is in this direction, right? But you will still go, your body will go backward. Because there you are reacting to it. You are reacting to the motion of your feet. Exactly. It's exactly the same thing. Your body, the part of you that touches the car, is trying to turn with the car because the car is exerting a force on you. The rest of the body cannot follow it. So if I just push his feet in this direction, of course he will fall down in that direction. But that's not because there is a force acting on you in that direction. That is because I'm just pushing his feet in that direction. Şimdi arabada olan şey, arabada viraj sağa dönerken, sonuçta kimi kısımlarınız arabanın koltuğuna, kenarına değiyor. Araba o bölgeleri sağa doğru itecek. Vücudunuzun diğer tarafı düz gitmeye çalışacak. Şimdi bir tarafınız sağa giderken diğer tarafınız düz kalırsa devrilirsiniz. Arabada olan olay da o. In the car, the points that touch the car when the car turns a right turn, the points that touch the car, they are moving right. But the other parts are not moving. So if one part of your body goes to the right, the other part doesn't do anything, then what you feel is you cannot just stand right, but you just lean to one side. And that's what's happening in the car. When you are sitting in the car, the car takes a right turn, your top part of your body doesn't want to move, so you have to apply, you have to apply through your body a force on your upper parts, or the door of the car will apply that force to you. Or imagine you are going inside a car, inside an autobus, inside a bus, which you do not have these days on campus, but imagine the good old days when we had the buses. So the car, you are standing, you couldn't find a seat, so you are standing, the car takes a right turn. So what happens? You just lean to one direction. So what is happening here? The force is acting on your hand, which is pushing you in that direction. So that is the only force acting, well, there's also the gravity, but that is the only force acting on you. The bus is trying to push you in one direction. Give me your hand. I'm pushing him in this direction. Of course, his body will not react immediately, so he will feel some tension, but he will come with me. And the same thing happens in the bus. The bus pushes you. If you want to resist it, you just lean backwards. But nevertheless, you are not strong enough to stop that motion. So at the end of the day, you start turning with the car, with the bus. Otobüste. Tutuyorsunuz. Otobüs sola döndü. Şimdi sol sağ ile ilgili şöyle bir problemim var arkadaşlar. İlkokulda sol ve sağ, sağ el yazı yazdığınız el diye öğretildi. Ben solağım. Okay, translation. I have a problem with left and right. I always confuse them. And the problem is, in high school we were taught that the right hand is the hand that you use to write. I'm left-handed. So I use my left hand to write. So whenever I'm talking about the left, I quite often use right. Okay, so you are in the bus. No, I was doing the Turkish one. Otobüste gidiyorsunuz. I'm just repeating what I said about the bus in Turkish. Tuttunuz. Otobüs sola döndü. Ne yapacaksınız? İki tarafa kayacaksınız. Sanki bir tarafa kuvvet hissediyormuşsunuz gibi. Otobüs de öbür tarafa gidecek. Burada tuttuğum el aslında otobüs bana oradan bir kuvvet uyguluyor. Beni o tarafa doğru çekiyor ki ben de o tarafa doğru döneyim. Bana etki eden kuvvet bir o var, bir de kütle çekimim var. Tabii de şey var, normal kuvvet var. This is what's happening. There is no force pushing you backward. It is just the bus is running away from you. Araba siz, otobüs sizden kaçıyor, siz de onu yakalamaya çalışıyorsunuz. Just like if I hold him and pull him, he will resist to me. So that's why he will just lean backwards if he wants to resist. Well, you are trying to resist the bus moving. So that's why you are leaning to one side. But of course the bus is much stronger than you, so you just follow the bus. Your feet. You are just your feet. Gravity. You see, if I exert a smaller force, I'm here, I'm trying to turn in that direction, okay? So if I exert a smaller force on my left hand, the gravity will push me in that direction, right? Friction, of course, it plays a role. The friction prevents my feet from running away. Well, I don't know. I don't really know. Do you know? Aranızda yapabilen var mı? Okay, show it. So what is the trick? So the trick is, show it again. So he says that you have to press this feet stronger than the other one. No. Okay. Do it slowly. Okay, so that this is the first step. Okay, so he's standing on this feet, on this foot, and pulling the other feet back. The other foot. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you see the trick. He's standing on this one. So the friction force between this foot and the floor is much larger than the other friction force. So when he moves that leg, it just moves because this friction force is much stronger. He should understand physics. Well, let's see. Yapışınca der, nereye yapışıyor? Well, you see, if you lean, you are changing the normal force. Okay, so there are a few effects over there. One thing is those who sit down, their feet not touching anywhere, so they are sitting down. So the only effect between the bus and you is from the seat that you are sitting. So the seat just is going that direction. So this part of your body will be moving in that direction. Now, in the other case, you are standing up. One example. So your feet is over there. So your feet are trying to move in that direction. Okay. Now, if I push him from here, he just goes backwards. Okay. But if I push him from the legs, he will have a harder life to balance himself. We will discuss these things when we are discussing rotations. What affects the rotation? I mean, the same force will have different rotational effects depending on where at which point you are applying the force. So if you are leaning towards the bus, again, you are changing the point where the force is applying to. And one more thing, if you are just sitting towards the floor, you will feel it even less. Yes. Bu kadar ne yaptık? Okay. Well, if you are swimming, okay. So you are immersed in water. Okay. Around you there is an engine that will, you have a submarine filled with this water. And you are free to move in this water. But of course you are floating on top. Okay, so you are not sinking down, you are just flying, right? So if you don't do anything, you will just hit the ceiling of the submarine. Yeah, I mean, we are just first setting up the scene. Bir denizaltıdayız, denizaltı suyla dolu, arkadaşınız da içinde. Bir dakika, arkadaşınız anlatsın. Akvaryum var. Okay, so the question is this one. We have this truck, let's say. On the back of the truck, there is a pool. Oh, you have a large fantasy. And he is swimming inside this pool. So the car is accelerating. What will happen to him? Well, if his density is larger than the pool, he will just sink. He will not be swim. No. You don't sink. In the pool. Oh yeah, in the pool you are sinking. But I think he is assuming that you are not sinking, so you are floating on top of the water, right? Yes. So what will happen to him? Anything else? Well, he's flying. Yani suyun üzerinde havada duruyor. Ama suyun en tepesinde duruyor. He's standing on top of the water. He's not flying yet. Okay, so have you watched the water glass when the car is accelerating? Yeah. So the surface of the water is tilted. So he's on the surface. So when the truck starts to accelerate, the water will be tilted in such a way that nothing will move on the surface. The fluids are always in such a shape that in the surface, there is no flow of fluid on the surface. So if the pool was initially like this, the car accelerates, for an observer inside the car, they will be feeling a push backwards, so some water will just go backward from the front. So the new shape of the surface of the water will be like this, and your friend will just stay there. Well, of course, during this water flow, you might go a bit back. But once that passes, the surface will be just like this, and you will just stay there. You'll stay there as long as the truck accelerates. Well, that was why I was planning to put you in a submarine. Because if you are in a submarine but floating, if the submarine accelerates, well, you can't talk about the surface, you are not on the surface. In that case, you will move forward in the submarine. Well, that is a submarine. Inside the submarine, you are floating inside the submarine. Well, some rope will be holding you in between, just like a helium-filled balloon. Well, you can be considered as an oxygen-filled balloon or nitrogen. You just stay there. As the submarine accelerates in that direction, just like the helium case, you will be inside the submarine again. To an observer inside the submarine, you will move forward. In an inertial reference frame, though, you will be moving again forward, the water will be again accelerating forward, well, you will be accelerating more because the water will try to stay where it is. It has a larger density. For a rock inside the water, inside the same submarine, the rock will just go towards the back of the submarine because the submarine is moving faster, accelerating faster. So you'll have such a puzzled face. Şimdi denizaltımız var. Denizaltı arkadaşınız asılı duruyor havada. Bir iple yere bağlanmış denizaltının yerine. Her taraf suyla kaplı. Bir de taşımız var. Taş da bir iple tavana bağlanmış. Şimdi denizaltı ileri doğru ilerliyor. Ne olacak? Sorumuz bu. Yani helyum dolu balonla, oksijen dolu balonla olan aynı hikaye aslında. Helyum dolu balon gibi arkadaşınız da denizaltının önüne doğru gidecek, hareket edecek. Taş da denizaltının arkasına doğru hareket edecek. Ama şeyleri karıştırmayın. Taş geriye doğru gitmeyecek. Bütün denizaltı ileri doğru gidecek. Her şeye ileri doğru bir kuvvet etki ediyor. Sadece taşa daha az bir kuvvet etki edecek denizaltıya etki edenden. Daha az bir kuvvet etki edecek. Arkadaşınıza da daha fazla bir kuvvet etki edecek. Değişen şey yok. Bu kuvvetin farkı da suyun kaldırmasından kaynaklı bir fark. Because of the buoyancy of the water, the rock will feel a bit less force per mass than the submarine, and your friend will feel a bit larger force per mass than the submarine because of the buoyancy of the water. İçindeler. Denizaltı da suyun dibinde ya da her neredeyse. No, he has some breathing equipment. He is doing some scuba diving. Okay, so this is a question that I expected in the last lecture. And the summary of the question is, the satellites that are in orbit, they are making free fall. That is what I claim. They are freely falling. Aren't they supposed to fall on Earth? Right? So why don't they fall on Earth if they are making a free fall? Pardon, arkadaşınız el kaldırdı. Why? I mean, right. Your friend's answer is that because it is taking the shortest path. Well, there is such a principle, but currently we are just doing Newton dynamics. So within Newton dynamics, what is our answer? So what? I mean, when I take this one and throw it to you, it is making a free fall and it is falling down eventually. The satellites are making free fall. Okay, so what you are not saying is that, so they have a velocity, so they have a centrifugal force. What is balancing what? There is only one force. There is nothing to balance that force. So what is balancing? Oh, that was another problem in your quizzes. Most of you wrote the total force is the force, the tension force plus the velocity. Velocity is not a force. It doesn't create any force. Velocity is not a force. The acceleration in circular motion is always towards the center of the Earth. The orbits are making a free fall towards the center of the Earth. They are falling. Yeah. Again, another centrifugal force example. There is only one force. If the velocity is increasing, the force doesn't change. If you are at this point, the force is constant, given by the gravity, independent of the velocity. Yes. Hold on. Let him finish. Okay. The gravity. Well, you are almost getting there. He's almost getting there. Hold on. Well, there's only one force acting on my satellite. The other force is acting on Earth, but my satellite doesn't care about it. So your friend was trying to say something. But the Earth is running away. Uydular sürekli düşüyorlar ama dünya yuvarlak olduğu için dünyanın yüzeyi de uydudan sürekli uzaklaşıyor. O yüzden bir türlü çarpamıyor. Well, as the satellites are moving, they are constantly falling towards the center of the Earth. But the surface of the Earth is also constantly running away because we're talking about a sphere. So the satellite is here. It has an initial velocity in that direction. So there will be nothing that will change that speed. It is falling down, meaning that it has the gravitational acceleration. So it will be accelerating in this direction. So just like this parabolic free fall. It is falling towards Earth, but it is just missing Earth. It misses the surface. So that's why it cannot hit. I mean, just imagine like this. Where's our experimental setup? Right, exactly the same. You should run. No. Circular motion. Run. Well, this is a small area. You see, I'm constantly pulling him. He's constantly running towards me, but I am also running away. So he cannot hit me. The same phenomenon. He was in my, well, we are more or less the same mass. So we are just orbiting each other. Yes. So we are both turning around each other, right? We are also turning around any point in here. This point is fixed. I'm not fixed, but he's turning around me. I see him here, he there, on that direction. Well, it doesn't make sense. I mean, it is how you describe your problem. Remember when we were choosing a coordinate axis, we chose an origin. That's kind of arbitrary. I can say that he's turning around. We can say that Earth is turning around Moon, or Moon is turning around Earth. Or they are both turning around the point in between. Which point? Any point. But of course, in one of these descriptions, the description will be simple. In the other one, it will not be simple. Remember Kepler's times. The orbits they had, well, I mean, they had weird shapes. Because when they looked at the planets, they saw their position. And so they were discussing the orbit of the planets with respect to Earth. That's a valid description. But it just makes things appear so complicated, you cannot see the simple pattern in there. So what Kepler did was, he wrote the orbits, the position of the planets, with respect to Sun. He knew the position of the Sun, he knew the position of the planets, so he could write the position of the planets with respect to Sun, then he could see the simple patterns there. So both descriptions are valid. None of them were wrong. But the problem is how you interpret those. In one description, it is simpler. In the other one, it's much harder. That is why one of the reasons also why we are sticking to inertial reference frames. What you should stick to inertial reference frames. Where the force acting on a person sitting in the car that takes a left turn is towards the left. Other questions? Yes. Now, one thing is we didn't yet discuss about rotation. So we don't really know much about how to answer that. But the answer is, now you can apply everything we know, even to rotating objects, as long as you talk about the center of mass. So whatever we are discussing here will hold. Up to now, we are only assuming that everything is point-like. Now, for extended objects, whatever we do will still hold for point masses, for the center of mass. Well, for extended masses, for the center of mass point. So if you just discuss the acceleration, with respect to the center of mass, when the sun disappears, well, let me first repeat the question. The question was, in one of the questions we discussed, we were discussing what happens if the sun disappears suddenly. We said that the trajectory of the Earth after that moment is a straight line. Your friend is asking that we know that Earth is rotating. Wouldn't that have any effect on the trajectory of Earth? Now, the answer is, for the center of mass, no. The center of mass will still go as a straight line. Yeah, the center of mass of Earth is at the center of the Earth. You are not at the center of the Earth. And of course, your motion will not be a straight line. As the center moves along a straight line, you will be just turning around with the Earth. So this is what your orbit will look like. It will be quite complicated. But the center will still go through a straight line. Other questions? Do you like this way of lecture? Now, we can continue like this. But I do ask you to read before coming. Because you see, in most of the chapters, the topic is quite short. And we can just, I can just tell you what the topic is in, I don't know, like 15 minutes. Most of the rest is just certain applications. In a lecture like this, I will not be able to do those applications on the blackboard, or I can still continue making the slides, but I will not be doing them in class. So you have to read those applications. Otherwise, you will not be learning anything. Okay? So we will continue like this. Well, we can still use the projector to have some questions. Okay, for the time being, we are still considering point masses. When we discuss the center of mass and how an object behaves under rotations, then ask me again. Okay. By the way, if you want, we can give a break now, a 10-minute break, or if you want, we can just continue. So who wants to give a break? Raise your hands. Okay, you are what? Okay, let's go. In 10 minutes, come back and ask your question then.